that 1 in 10 Filipino couples find it difficult to conceive a child. A survey commissioned by a private company shows that the reason behind a couple's inability to conceive can range from medical illnesses to their lifestyle. We're still talking about infertility and the treatment options available for couples trying to conceive. We still have with us Drs. Maria Concepcion Ila Oreta and Dr. Ina Irabon. Doctor, before we tackle on the treatment modalities, earlier we mentioned a lot of things, a lot of signs for the female part of infertility. How about for the males? Are there any telltale signs that the male may have problems with fertility?
You know what we tell the infertile couple when they come into our offices? Their very first consult, we always give them a request for semen analysis, because that's the only thing that we need from the man. If the results are normal, then he's okay, he's fine. But of course, we may need to repeat that after 6 weeks. Mm-hmm. Okay, so semen analysis is very important, because 40% of infertile couples may involve the male.
In the evaluation of infertility, the focus should be on the couple, not just on the male partner, mm-hmm. not just on the female partner. Because that's the misconception in infertility. Oftentimes, it's only the female partner that mm-hmm. comes in our mm-hmm. clinic, just because they say that, my partner already mm-hmm. has a child from a previous relationship. You know, when evaluating an infertile couple, that joint visit by the male and female partner.
Now, Dr. Ina, is it possible for a woman to still get pregnant even after having a miscarriage?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And the treatment would largely depend on the cause of the recurrent pregnancy loss. That's what we call recurrent pregnancy loss, when there are two or more consecutive spontaneous miscarriages. Okay. So what are the causes of recurrent pregnancy loss? Could be genetic, anatomic, you know, some intrauterine anatomic disorders like uterine septum, a fibroid perhaps, polyps, and it could be a thrombophilia, immunologic in the form of antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, could be a hormonal, metabolic, endocrinologic, and for that woman to successfully carry a baby to term in her next pregnancy, maybe we can do treatment specific for the cause of the recurrent pregnancy loss.
Would you like to add something to what she said? Regarding the polyps, actually there are no studies proving that polyps can really cause miscarriages. But it's good to be taking them out, because there may be some other pathology rather than an endometrial polyp. So we look inside, we do hysteroscopy, and look inside the uterine cavity. Now, regarding the myoma as a cause of a recurrent miscarriage, only if the myoma is a submucous type will it be a possible cause of, so it's intrauterine.
Okay.
It's within the cavity of the uterus. But if it is like, because other patients might think, the audience might think that, I have a myoma, this might be the cause, but it's a subserous myoma. Yes. It's outside, just on top of the uterus. Mm-hmm. So that will not cause recurrent miscarriage.
Okay. Now, Dr. Ching, is in vitro fertilization, or IVF, the only recourse for a couple who is having difficulty conceiving, or are there other modalities available?
No, actually, if the male factor is not so severe, then we may do artificial insemination using the husband's sperm, because we wash the sperms and then we concentrate, we activate the sperms, and then we put that inside the uterine cavity.
Okay.
But I just want to remind everyone that we need to check the woman also. We need to make sure that her fallopian tubes are open. We need to make sure that she's really ovulating. And there is also another diagnostic test and therapeutic test as well. It's we call it laparoscopy, pelvic laparoscopy. It's a small incision in the navel, and then we look inside the cavity of the uterus. Because oftentimes, even if the transvaginal ultrasound is normal, the patient can have endometriosis and not diagnosed by the physician, because there's no endometriosis, an ultrasound, there's no adenomyosis. But clinically, we may be able to detect that.
Okay. Any final words or advice, Dr. Ina, for our audience with regards to infertility?
Well, infertility is not really, I know this is an emotional burden for an infertile couple, but you know, there are so many treatment choices for infertility. We're not only limited to natural intercourse or even purely from ovarian stimulation, but there are other alternative treatments such as in vitro fertilization, intrauterine insemination. I just want to remind the audience that it is very important to seek consult right away. Mm-hmm. Maybe probably get two opinions at least, so you can make a decision on how to go about the fertility workup and treatment.
Mm-hmm.
And it's important that you do this first rather than, you know, so you can plan ahead. Thank you.
And when we come back, can counseling help a couple trying to conceive? We will be talking to a sex therapist for questions you might be too embarrassed to ask. You're watching MedTalk on CNN Philippines.